guys, William Inferno here today with a new review for you guys, but surprise, I'm also going to be unboxing it in this review, but from the title, you already know what this is. I'm not going to, like, spend so much time doing this. I just want to carry out the excitement on camera, if that's okay with you guys. If not, you can skip through this section. I'm just going to do this really quick because I like unboxings. I think it's fun to open the package and show you guys, like, my first-hand experience with stuff that I get. So, let's just... what we got in here. Oh, it's interesting. It looks like it's kind of like glue, almost. Either that or I'm just stupid. It looks like the packaging is... it's like glued on there. Here we go. Wow, okay, so this packaging is really nice compared to the packaging I got last week. But, right, so here it is. This is the LEGO Bionicle Summer 2015. This is the Summer 2015 polybag with the villain Culta Golden Culta mask in it. So, just looking at the cover here, we see we got some stuff in here. We got a stand, we got the Golden Culta mask. It's 13 pieces. If you're under 7, you might not want to do this, but you might want to because it's not really, like, anything bad. And then we have Master Creation, and on the back just have some stickers, probably from the store that he got it from. No big deal there. So, I actually like to keep the packaging, even for polybags, because, you know, for stuff like this where it's not released widely, since I ordered this from overseas, I like to keep the packaging just because it's kind of worth something to me. Because, you know, you're not gonna find this packaging in the US, so I'm only gonna cut, like, the bare top off of it, so I can keep most of the graphic here. And I know some of you guys are like, one of those people, but yeah, I am, and I'm okay with that. Like, I think some of this stuff could be valuable, and I want to make sure that it stays alright. And as you can see there, I already kind of ripped the packaging a little bit, which I'm okay with, like, as long as I don't tear it in half. I just want to make sure I get it open without tearing too much of the packaging here. I guess this is good enough. Alright, so let's pull some stuff out here. Illuminati confirmed. We have a Makuta eye here in the shape of a triangle. So, Bionicle is now Illuminati confirmed. Alright, and then we have... oh, okay, so this is actually pretty full. Alright, so we have this little instruction booklet here. It tells you how to put this all together. So it looks like it's built primarily like a stand from the Mask of Creation. And then it comes with just a little graphic of everything here. So, really nice little instruction booklet there. We have these awesome pad parts. These are actually really nice. And I guess there's two of them. And yeah, so one goes on top, one goes on bottom. Oh, and then, oh, this is amazing. We have this glossy gold with, oh, this is so cool. You see, I haven't really looked at this yet, but holy crap, guys. This is really, really nice how it shines. Oh, that's just, that's really cool. And then we have this little bag of parts here. So let's just see if we can rip that open. I hate how sometimes these bags are made with this type of plastic, because this type of plastic is stretchy and it doesn't like to open as easily. Try not to cut my fingers off there. That would be unfortunate. Alright, so we got the bag open. Did we? Yeah, maybe? Yes, we did. Alright, so I guess the only piece worth noting here is the Golden Culta mask. Alright, so first off, let's just take a look at this unfolded platform sort of base. I really like the picture over here with the Mask of Creation and Makuta's eyes hover just above it with the skull spiders coming in on each side. That's really, really cool. And then on the back here, we actually have this really, really... I'm sorry, I just love the artwork, and I just love the style that they're choosing for this. This LEGO Bionicle in the middle, and then just all the elements on all sides. I just think that's really cool. Alright, so here it is. I did my best to flatten the pad out, but it's folded when it comes in, so it's obviously not going to stay completely flat. I was actually surprised at how the instructions didn't actually completely show you the assembly too well. Like, I sort of figured it out on my own. There's like little flaps, and you have to put the flaps inside of these little holes. But, I mean, the instructions didn't really show that very well, so I actually spent quite a bit of time just kind of trying to figure it out on my own. But in the end, it looks just like it does on the cover, and I think it worked out really well. I just have to point out how great this stand looks. I know it's cardboard, but this is turning out way better than I thought it would, just because it is cardboard. The Golden Cult mask sits really nicely against the lime green color that this stand sort of gives off. And I kind of start to see why they might not have released this in the US. I'm not saying that they shouldn't have. I'm not saying that the US shouldn't get this, but it obviously didn't, because this came out back in August. So if they were going to release it in the US, they would have already, and this has only been released in Russia and possibly other parts of Europe, though I'm not quite sure on that. I am positive on Russia. And I can just kind of tell just because of how much effort they put into this, and I guess that's sort of not true, because you'd think if LEGO put a lot of effort into something, they'd sort of want to sell more of it. But I actually think it's just because they didn't want to make so much of it, because there's a lot of cardboard and a lot of, printing going on here, and I'm not sure LEGO wanted to mass produce it, because it probably, I'm not gonna lie, I mean, it looks like they spent quite a bit of money just making this and all the detailing on it, but I could totally be wrong. That is just my view on it. I just really like it a lot, and I just think it's just a really nice way to display the Golden Cultamask, though. I feel like if we're going to display the Golden Culta mask like this, which, I mean, it's not even that big of a mask, it doesn't have any story relevance, why wouldn't we want to display the Mask of Creation in a more proper, noble way? But, you know, LEGO's LEGO, they'll do what they'll do. So now I'm going to show you what it looks like compared to the actual Culta and Skull Warrior masks, and then I'm going to show you the Golden Mask on Culta and Skull Warrior. Alright, so here we have the gunmetal one next to the light silver one next to the pearl gold. And I mean, I guess I can't really compare them because they're the exact same mold, but I just think it's really nice how they all kind of fit the same shiny metallic colors, and they might work with each other, I guess. I just have to point out how much I really do like the design of this skull mask, but I won't spend too much time on this because I know you guys already know what this looks like. So let's go ahead and put it on Culta. Or actually, you know, let's start with Skull Warrior. Alright, so obviously you can tell there's bright colors on Skull Warrior, so the gold actually works in my opinion. And you know, I'm gonna get probably a bit of hate saying that, because everyone's gonna be like, it's gold, Furno. It obviously does not work on a color scheme that has no other gold in it. But you know, I think it just works with the bright colors, because this gold is a very bright pearl gold, and I just think it works with the set, to be honest. I mean, I don't really find anything wrong with it, because it's a gold mask, it's kind of supposed to stand out. I also just really like how the red eyes go behind that gold mask. That just looks really creepy and really, really cool. So yeah, you know, I think it works on Skull Warrior. So, now on to Culta. And once again, on Culta, I just think this looks really nice, because I think it complements the Trans Orange. And again, I feel like I'm gonna get a bit of hate for this, because, you know, I mean, people don't really like contradicting color schemes, and with this flash of gold on here, it doesn't exactly look right. But, you know, he's kind of the big royal boss. I mean, as much hate as the set gets, I think the gold mask sort of adds that he is like the leader of the Skull Warriors and Scorpio and, you know, everything else. So, you know, I think it works on both Skull Warrior and Culta. I think it complements both of them, it gives them more of a royal look, and, you know, I think, honestly, I just really love the gold color in the mask. Alright, so this has been my quick look or review or unboxing of the Golden Culta Mask Villain Polybag set of Summer 2015. So I finally have completed my collection of all of the accessible parts of 2015. The only one I haven't gotten, which I don't plan to get because, dang, that's way too much money, is the Trans Blue Golly Mask, which there's only 200 of in existence. And that is just crazy for me. I mean, I'm a completionist, but I'm not that much of a completionist. Like, I will not spend I don't think I'll spend more than, like, 40 bucks, 50 bucks on a collectible mask. And trust me, I only spent, like, 6 bucks on this one. So, yeah, overall, I really like it. I think it's really nice how they just presented this all. And in the comments, tell me below, do you like the idea of a gold Culta mask? And do any of you actually have it? Because I know it's kind of scarce in the US, especially since it wasn't released here. But it's also really hard to find now since most of them are kind of sold out. At least I checked eBay and there's like none on there. And then I just bought like the only one on Bricklink. Although there is another seller selling them, it's just that he demands that you buy them in mass, kind of masses. So, I mean, you'd have to buy like 80 something of them, and that still wouldn't be enough money because it's like his lowest price that you can pay him is like $80 or something. So, yeah, you need, if you're gonna buy from him, you need to buy like 80 of them, which is not entirely a bad idea, but I would not spend so much money on multiple of these masks. I only wanted one, and I scored one late night when Bricklink seller updated his page with one of these, and I was like, wow, okay, I need to get it. So, yeah, if you guys can score one of these, I definitely recommend picking it up. It's a really nice little set here. I definitely think it's a better turnout than the one that was released in March of 2015, which was the trans orange Tapu mask. And I really like this one. I'm not going to give it a rating since it's not really a set that's qualified for any sort of out of 10 rating. But yeah, anyway, the only Bionicle 2015 review I still have to do is on the chapter book 2, which is Revenge of the Skull Spiders, which I'm actually picking up tomorrow. I ordered one to get into my store, so I'm going to pick that up tomorrow since they updated me and they're like, hey, we got the book. So yeah, and then after that I'm going to do a complete overview of 2015 books, media, sets, polybags, collectibles, all of that. I don't know if it's going to be a really long video since I'm going to try to like skim through it all. Because you guys have already kind of lived through 2015 with me. So, this has been my, you know, stuff about the Golden Cult of Mask. If you enjoyed this review and you're not subscribed, I can't force you to do anything, but I have more Bionicle content on my channel, so if you're into that, yeah. And then, yeah, I'll see you guys later.